Hey, everybody. I'm Tristan Sean Gregson here with David the Ocho Ochoa, who is too busy to even come by the booth to talk to me. In fact,
my priorities straight. I have to get, you know, start getting my card signed.
We're here very close to Rob Alexander, which is about as close as I can get. And we're also, I just want to point out, much like Connolly, you came straight from the airport.
Well, I have to wear my airport clothes. No belt, no medal, so I don't have to fuss with the medal detector.
Agreed.
You have to plan this stuff ahead. It's very important.
He's made it very true. Are you familiar with the Scars spoiler?
A little bit.
Okay. We're just going to talk about a few cards and what your initial thoughts are. I'm getting the whole spectrum of pros. It's been very entertaining so far. So I'm going to say David the Ocho, Venser the Sojourner, go.
That's the one that flickers stuff in and out, right?
Yes. Make some stuff unblockable, and if you get an emblem, you can eventually just cast stuff and exile things.
Well, I have to say that, you know, Moldrifter was pretty sweet, so flickering your Moldrifter is probably going to be pretty sweet also. Especially in EDH, where people are probably going to play this card and not standard.
There it is. I was like, oh, extended.
You know, a month after the set comes out and everyone's playing four and they're like $100 each, people can say, yeah, Ocho, you were wrong. But until then, it's not going to happen.
Wow. Harsh, strong, and words I agree with. Anything else to say about Venser before we move on?
No.
Okay, that was easy. Elspeth Tyrell, go.
You'll have to remind me what she does.
Okay. She's the 5 cast it costs Elspeth. She's a little more costly. She's a little bit. She's high priced now these days. Comes into play with 4 loyalty. +1, you gain 1 life for each creature you control. -2 to put 3 dudes into play. Minus. What's +2? So it's I'm finding +2 life or plus
your effects right.
Really interesting. That was +1. We'll go to the. There'll be a picture behind us.
So
we'll be making fun of it.
+2, -2, and
-5. Destroy all other. So she lives in theory. Lands and tokens. Sorry, everything.
Non-land.
See, I've been thrown off. Sorry, everything that's not a land or a token
this
or an Elspeth.
This is thrown into the extra feature.
No, this is Tim shoots the whole thing.
Sounds fine.
Sounds fine.
Yeah.
I have so much to say about Venser, nothing to say about Elspeth.
Well, yeah, I don't actually know what Elspeth does. I mean, okay, it's like -1, -2, -5.
She puts some guys into play.
Yeah.
She chains well. This is what Lisa and I are talking about. You play her, you make some guys.
Right,
you
yeah.
make some more guys, she dies. You play the next one on top of it. She has an army of people in front of her. And then you can do other stuff.
Yeah, as long as she can defend herself, then sure.
Now, again,
a lot of
people I've been talking to, is it like Cloud Goat Ranger? Is it like a delayed Nevin Jarl's disc? Like, it's fighting with spots with Gideon, Baneslayer, Angel. Do you think it will have a shot in the new standard to be in a deck?
Absolutely.
Don't say anything else.
No, I mean, we want to sell.
You've already broken it. Yeah. We want to sell. You and I see any of that money. We're done.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
Lastly, on the Planeswalker topic, we've got Koth the Hammer.
I saw that one. I was
good. Now you can talk about it.
Browsing the internet, but I forgot what it does.
Christ!
It's 4 mana. It's red. It's got loyalty.
So you do plan on playing it, is what you're saying?
Hopefully not.
2 red, 2 other. Comes to play with 3 loyalty. +1. Untap a mountain. It becomes a 4/4.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
-2 loyalty. Add mana. Red mana to your pool equal the number of mountains you have in play.
Oh, and then the ultimate is
you get an emblem. It's -5, and you can tap. Oh, you like flame fuselage.
Flame fuselage.
Forever.
Forever. Well. It seems like it's like Obsidian Fireheart, but with a little more reach. I mean, that's what Red was looking for. One of the things. It sort of ran out of cards and ran out of things to do, and then this guy does that.
He does a lot of stuff. I think. I mean, so many people say you play him, and then next turn you dump your hand, or you play him, and all of a sudden it's like Locke said it right. It's Lava Hounds, but it's all on the upside. There's no downside.
Ooh, Lava Hounds. There was a lot of downside with that card.
See, now you're thinking. Now I got you thinking. I said Lava Hounds, now you're thinking. No Lava Runner, but Lava Hounds.
Well, yeah, I know. All I can think about at Lava Hounds is the flavor text.
Okay. Let's think about how good the card might be. You've heard what this guy does. What do you think?
Yeah, it seems fine.
It seems fine.
Yeah. I mean, I'm pretty reserved, so.
Okay.
Still fine is probably awesome.
Perhaps you've forgotten the first 3 minutes of this interview.
No. No.
There's this jet lag.
Yeah, speaking of jet lag, I am so bummed. I am waking up at 4 a.m. in the morning every day. It's just awful.
Oh, right. Because of all that pro touring.
Yeah, I didn't play on day 2.
That is a little rough.
Yeah, it was.
Let's talk about something you do know.
Okay.
That would be Vintage, that would be Moxes.
Sure.
Mox Opal.
Don't like it.
Okay. Ooh, now I want to hear. Why?
Well, it's... Okay, so... The best game... Or the best deck it's going to be in is an all-artifact deck. And it needs other artifacts to be good. So that's not actually going to happen a lot unless you have a bunch of cheap artifacts. And it doesn't help the hands that suffer from a lack of mana, or suffer from having no mana. and it just seems inconsistent, especially since the legendary. I mean, you could play four if you really wanted to, which is, it's not as good as Chromox in a deck like Ad Nauseam, for example. But
now, one thing, I mean, I'm trying to think of like the Ad Nauseam lists where a lot of times Chromox get cast empty. This one, like the first one and the third one, add mana.
Well, they don't add mana because of legendary, so they're going to go to the graveyard when you check.
The first one adds mana. The second one makes them go away. The third one comes into play and adds mana.
I don't know about that.
Not too sold. They talk to the other deck that was all artifacts. So workshop decks, you don't think this card has any place?
No.
You're not a big fan of brown decks to begin with.
No, I think they're good. They're not good. They're powerful, but
they're playable.
Yeah, I certainly wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole.
Okay. I'm a big fan of Trinisphere. I'm a big fan of Lodestone Golem. I mean, the problem is you go workshop this thing.
Yeah, and it just doesn't do anything. It just sits there, and it's like you're looking, and it's like, wow, I spent X dollars on this, and it's not even tapping for mana. I can't do anything. It's
Mox Opal would really make me wish that Mishra's Workshop was an artifact, and the fact that I have to wish that Mishra's Workshop was anything other than what it was pretty much tells me this is a bad card.
Yeah, I'm not sold on the new Mox. I think Wizards has done a good job at neutering their free mana.
They're almost as smart as we are now.
Yeah, anything to do with free mana is a mistake. Free mana, free spells, just don't even think about it. Just push in the back corner.
In the same interview, we're talking about Koth, this guy that can add mana. I mean, it's not really free necessarily, but if this guy lives a turn, all of a sudden you get a lot of red mana.
Yeah, but I mean, it has a high initial cost.
Okay. I mean, different than free. Different than free.
Yeah. I mean, Seething Song is definitely not Rite of Flame. Just like Koth is not
Seething
Song.
Yeah. Fair enough. You've got a line to get back to. I've got to go find other people to talk to, and we'll get you a change of clothes. We'll get you a shirt.
Yeah, I've got my clothes packed. You'll see me in full gear tomorrow.
I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, except with the beanie. No beanie at all.
Okay. Well, I'll let you back to the line. We'll see you in action tomorrow, and then I'll have your top eight interview on Sunday.
Well, I figure I'll probably be done with the tournament after round six, after my three buys, and then I have to go X2 to make. Yeah, okay. Around six, we can talk a lot.
The eternal optimist, David the Ocho Ochoa. Grand Prix Portland. That's where we are. Thanks for watching.